So we get to the last step of the technique, in which once we have generated test case specifications, we create test cases starting from these specifications. This step mainly consists in a simple instantiation of frames, and its final result is a set of concrete tests. For our example, test frame number 36 that we just saw, this will be the resulting test case, which has the same ID so that we can track it, and that will specify to concrete values, not just a specification, for the input elements. So string str will have this value, and the integer size will have this value. And these two values satisfy what the test case specification was, which was having a string that contains special characters. Here we have two special characters, like the new line and the tab, and we have a size which is greater than 0, in particular 10. And this is a test case that we can actually run on our code, that we can run on the split program. So to summarize, we performed 6 steps in which we went from a high-level description of what the program does to a set of concrete test cases. And this is one of those test cases. So what we're going to do next, we're going to do a mini demo in which we do this for real. We take the program, we identify categories, choices, constraints, and we actually generate test frames and then test cases.